So good morning to all. So today we'll start with entropy. As I said in the previous classes, to measure the impurity we have three metrics. One already we discussed, that is Gini index, and then today we'll start with the topic, that is metric is entropy. So entropy is used in ID3 and C4 form 5. They use the information gain as the entropy. So this is a formula for entropy. As we can see here, the entropy at particular node T will be the summation over number of class. This is the nothing but number of classes, and PJT. PJT is nothing but the relative frequency of class J at node T. And then we have discussed this formula earlier also. Now how will we use in this problem here? So now what will be the maximum value of the entropy? So when the all object is have equal probability to be in any classes, okay. So that is the equal probability is like, what will be the maximum, what will be the minimum value? First we talk about what is the minimum value, what will be the PJT, what is the maximum value of PJT if the all patterns belong to a single class, then it will be 1, and therefore this value entropy will be 0. But what will be the maximum value? So maximum value is for each class is equally probable, right. So suppose you have a total 100 objects, and then out of that 50 objects belong to class C1 and another 50 objects belong to class C2. So therefore, PJT for the each object at the node T, this is the node T, it will be up. So now if you take the summation over this value, then we will get the value log NC. Now we can compute what will be the value for the entropy value for this case here, it will be 0. Right, and then what will be the value of in this case, it will be log NC. What is the NC? NC is the number of classes, so it will be log 2 base 2, so it will be 1, and then we need to compute what will be the value of the entropy here. Now there is a term is called information gain. In earlier case also, in case of the impurity measure using Gini index, we have seen that there is also a term is called the gain. So here we talk about the gain. Let us say A be an attribute and it has the V distinct values, that is in earlier example we have the card type, there are three type of cards, okay. So then if we want to partition the particular node, then we should have a three different values. So in case of the earlier example, like in marital status, we had one values or divorce, another values was married, another value was single. So then in that case, what will be the combined entropy or what will be the information gain? So what will be the entropy at this node A in the similar line of the Gini index measures? So we will have a entropy, and then what will be the individual entropy of this node, and then we take the weighted sum, okay. So as I told earlier, so let us say if there are 100 objects, this is let us say 30, this is 60 and this is 10, then we will take the weighted sum of the individual entropy, so that is we talk about. So this will be the weighted sum of the individual entropy, that will give you the combined entropy, that means entropy after split. And then what will be the gain? Gain will be naturally the whatever the gain will be for the parent node and then combined. So that will give you the information gain. Now one example. So what will be the entropy for this case? What will be the entropy here? All are equally probable. So then it will be log NC. So this will be 1. Now if you use the attribute A, then what will be the entropy after split? So as I said, there is a node here, and then so this is N1 and this is N2, then what we ideally what we should do, we will compute the entropy. Entropy, we will compute the entropy of node N1, okay, and then we compute the entropy of node N2, and then we combine with weighted sum. Why weighted? So total is 7. Here we have 12. So then what will be the information gain? Information gain will be 1 minus what will be the combined value? This will come here, but it has some drawback. So, information gain is biased toward the test with many outcomes. Let us say with students, we have 100 students and roll number will be the one of the attributes. Okay. Now, if you split based on the student's ID or student's roll number, then what will happen? You have the 100 and then each student will have the its unique roll number. So, therefore, you can make the 100 children. So, you can make the, and ideally each of this node is, each of this node is pure, because there will be only one item, and then what will be the value of the entropy? Entropy will be 0. So, now if you sum up this all zeros here with weighted sum, so then what will be the total entropy here? That also will be 0. And then what is the gain? Gain will be 1 minus 0, so gain will be the maximum. So, therefore, if information gain is biased toward the test with many outcomes, that means if say if the new objects come or new student comes with new ID, so therefore you cannot place any one of the bucket here or any one of the bins here. So, what we learn later on is something called the generalization ability will be lost. So, we cannot place here out of this 100. So, therefore, what we see is if we have, we need to choose a particular attributes and then attribute has the many outcome. So, naturally that attribute always will be the best option for the splitting, but that may not be the always correct from the classification point of view. Because whenever new students come, you cannot trace this decision tree, because when new student, any one of this child, it will not go. Okay, you cannot trace, you cannot put any one of them, any one of the buckets. So, therefore, what we do it? So, if there are many outcomes, that means there may be some problem like this roll number or ID kind of thing may be there. So, but it is very difficult to identify. If we do everything is automated, everything if you want to do automated like algorithm, if I run it, then it is very difficult to identify whether it is a roll number is attributes or it is something else or the percentage of the student CGPA and so on. So, therefore, what can be done is like if there is a many outcome, so it should overcome that problem. So, that is something called the gain ratio. Okay. So, they introduce a term is called the gain ratio, by which if there is many outcome, we can identify and we can avoid that. So, that is the gain ratio overcome this bias. What is this bias? If there are many outcome, it naturally that attribute will be chosen, but many outcome may not lead the good results, okay, or it may mislead the classification problem itself. So, therefore, what is done is information gain is normalized by the split info. What is split info? So, split info of particular node is defined as the normalized by the entropy of the each node. Let us say here you have a 4 partition. So, then we have what is something called is we got the gain. Gain at the node A, that we will normalize by the split info. What is split info? Split info is something here is, as you can see, this is nothing but the is a probability here, and then same thing is here. So, this is something you can say is the entropy close to that one, entropy of that individual node. Okay. So what is V here? So but earlier what we are doing, we are summing over the classes. If you see the entropy formula, if you go back and see the formula, entropy, we can move back. This is actually over the classes, this summation over the classes. But if you see here, this is over the number of branches, okay. So that is, it is not exactly the entropy, but it is a very close to entropy. So then what is that? So for this one, we compute the log n1 by n. What is n1? N1 is the number of object reached at this node. So that is, we will take the log n1 by n, and then we will take the weighted sum. Weighted sum is, if there is, there are 100 objects, let us say this is 20, this is 60, this is 5, so, and then this is 15. So then weighted sum will be 20. So this will be 20 by 100 into log 20 by 100 plus 60 by 100 plus log 60 by 100 and so on. And whatever the values you will get it, that should appear in the denominator, and then in numerator we will get the gain A. So then what will be the advantage? In earlier example we are getting here is, we are getting some values here, then what we do it? So all will be 1. So then what will be the value here? So these value will be huge. So let us say for there are 100 objects, so each is having 1. So 1, so each is having 1, 1, 1, 1, okay. So then what will be the split info? What will be the split info information? There are 100 objects here. So what will be the value of split info? So you can just simply put it here. N1, 1 by 100 into log 1 by 100 here, and then how many term you will get? You will get 100 term here, so then you cancel it out, then you will have some minus log 1 by 100. So then minus 1 by 100 means, if you do it here computation, then say you can do it here, like it will be log 100 base 2. It is not exactly the entropy, right? Entropy will be 1, means it is 0. So now what we see is, if there are multiple outcome, this value will be more. It was 100, so in some cases it may be 200, or say it some cases 30. So gain will be the same for the all cases, let's say, but because of the there are many branches, so that is divided, so overall value will be less. So therefore actually split info will punish the gain. So as you see, it's log 100. And if there are say two partition, instead of say, let's say you had roll number, you took the roll number, and then you had the 100 partition, you got some gain is 1 divided by log 10 to base 2, okay. So let's say we divided by 1 by 7, close to 6, okay, 6 point something. And now if you have a only two partition, then what will be the value of here? So then it may be the value of will be like, so let's say if you have a two partition, then you take log 2 approximately, so you will get the 1 instead of 100. So then you divide it by whatever the value you got it. So that way, if the there are multiple outcome, so we are putting in denominator, so therefore it will punish the gain. Gain you may get with multiple partition, you may gain, it may be much higher, but we are dividing, we are normalizing with the split info. So that way we will remove the biasness toward the test with the many outcomes. Here gain split is what? That is the gain, information gain. Here is gain split is nothing but the information, and split info already we define it here. Now you have three scenario here, you can check, okay. What are those three scenario? One is cut type, another is, sorry, cut type we partition it to three part, that is we will have a node here 1, 2, 3. So this node is having 1, 3, another is 8, 0, another is 1, 7. Now you compute, this is not Gini, actually this is not Gini, it should be entropy. What will be the overall entropy? So overall entropy will be lesser than the any other cases, that is right, okay. Let us say this is instead of Gini you can consider, so this is entropy. So entropy is 0.163, this is also entropy, and let us say this is also entropy. Now what we can do it? So you compute the split info. So you got the split info 1.52, here split info 0.72, another is split info 0.97. And now what you have to do? You have to choose which one is the best, which one is the best option. So if you go for the simple entropy, so which one is the least entropy? So you got the least entropy is here. So we should choose this split. But obviously we have to check the gain. Okay. Now what you do it? We divide whatever we get the gain. So then we divide it by the split info. So now if you divide this value with this one or this value with this one, so you will see this may not be the best choice. Let us say here in cut type, okay, left side, that is this one, we are talking about this one. So then how do you compute the split info? How many objects it has? So this is 4 plus 8, 12, 12 plus 8, 20. So that at node there are 20 objects, okay. And then this node you have 4, this node you have 8, and this node you have 8. So then what will be the split info? So split info will be something summation over, or this is 4. So then 4 by 20 log 4 by 20 plus this is 8. So then 8 by 20 log 8 by 20 plus 8 by 20 log 8 by 20. Okay. Now you compute it, then you will get this value, that is 1.52 for this one. So that is split info. Okay. So now what is the gain? Gain you have to compute at this. So you had, what is that? You had 20. So gain, how do you compute the entropy? So you had 3 classes. So then summation over probability of j t into log of p j t, right? So what is this p j t? This class, what is the family? So you had in the, so if in the family, so family and then sports and then luxury, you had this distribution at this root. So this is 4, so this was 8 and this was 8, so at the root. So then you have, you will have 3 terms here. So that will be the entropy at the root node, and then individual entropy. So if this is the root, so you will get the entropy like this one, and then in individual entropy also you have to compute. Within this node there are, so there are 2 classes, right? So then in the root node there will be 10 objects will be C1 classes, so this is 10, and then another 10 object will be into C2 classes. So then equally distributed. So then equally distributed means what will be the entropy at the root node? So it will be 1. So entropy at this root node will be 1. And then you compute the entropy at this node. So what is the distribution? 1 and 3. So then here you will have the 2 terms always. So here is log 1 is 0. So 0 plus then another term is 3. Okay. So then 3 by 4 into, so we are getting 3 terms here. So that is one object belongs to class C1, another object belongs to class 3. So then probability of this class C1 is 1 by 3 into log 1 by 3 plus 3 by 1 by 4, 3 by 4 into log 3 by 4. So that will be the entropy for this node. And for this node, what will be the 8, 0? So what will be the entropy? 8 by 8 into log 8 by 8, so it will be 0. And then for this node it is 1,7. So it will be same, it will be negative of 1 by 8 into log 1 by 8 plus 7 by 8, yes, 7 by 8 into log 7 by 8. And then you have to combine with weighted sum. Okay. So, weighted sum here is 4, here is 8 and here is 8. Okay. So, and then if you subtract from the 1 minus this value, that will give you the information gain, and whatever information gain you get it by, it will be divided by the this split info. So, next we can see one example here with the gain ratio. So, here we go. So, here we have the three cases. So, it is a card type here, you can see. So, instead of Gini, you can consider this is entropy, instead of Gini, you can consider entropy, and instead of Gini, you can consider entropy. Okay. And then split info, we will get the split info 1.52, here is 0.7. Obviously, it has three part. So, as I said, if you have the many outcome, split info will be more. So, here it has three, so therefore, split info is more. And here it has two, so split info is less. So, then we divide it by the much larger number. So, then it will balance the, it will decide that which attribute we should take. Now, as I said in the beginning, that is three metrics, we already discussed two metrics. So, another leftover matrix is the classification error. So, what is classification error? That is defined is here is 1 minus max j p j t. So, maximum over the classes, p j t is as is the same definition like the relative frequency of the class j. So, one example here, suppose we reach a node, there are c 1 class and then another is c 2 class. So, there are 12 object in c 1 class and 5 object in c 2 class. So, now I have to say, and if it is the terminal node, then what will be the level of this terminal node? As I said in the decision tree, each terminal node will be level with the class level. So, now majority of the objects belongs to class C 1. So, therefore, what we say is this node's class level will be C 1. That there are two points here. One is if the all patterns or all objects belongs to a single class, then there is no partition, and that node will be the terminal node with the class level. There may be another situation where there are mixture of classes. So, as you see in this example C 1 and C 2, there are two classes, 12 objects belongs to class, 12 object belong to class C 1 and 5 object belong to class C 2. But here is mixture of objects. So, but if you want to give a name, so what you do it? We will say the majority of the pattern or majority of the object belongs to which class, that is C 1. So, we will give the name as C 1, we will label it as C 1. And if we do so, then what may happen? So, for the 5 objects, it will make the error. So, therefore, error rate will be 5 by 17, you got my point. So, for how many objects it is actually giving error? So, out of the 17, 12 you can identify rightly with the class level C 1, but 5 it will give error. So, therefore, error rate will be 5 by 17. So, that is written here. What is the classification error? That is 1 minus what is the maximum probability or what is the class, what is the probability of a class which is maximum. So, here what is C 1 class probability is 12 by 17 and 5 that C 2 class probability is 5 by 12 and which one is the maximum? So, 12 by 17. So, therefore, error will be 1 minus 12 by 17. So, this is 5 by 12. So, you reach a node and see the distribution of the each class. So, obviously, as I said is you should give a name where majority of the pattern belongs to that class. So, once you give that name, but rest of the classes you will do the mistake. So, therefore, classification error will be 1 minus what is the highest probable class. So that probability value, that is in this example 7. So I can talk another example here. Let's say instead of binary classification, you have a multi-class problem. So you have C1, C2, C3 and C4, and distribution is like that. Here is 60, here is 25, here is 5 and here is 10. So then if you give the name is C1 class, so then for these objects, so that is 30 plus 40 object, you will make mistake. So then therefore error rate will be 40/100. So that is written in its more formal way. So 1 minus maximum probability of the classes. So here maximum probability is 60. So 1 minus 60/100. So that will give you the 40/100. Okay. So what is the maximum and minimum value of the classification error? What is the minimum value? See, if the all pattern belong to single class, so therefore this maximum value is 1, so it will be 0. And what will be the maximum value? 1 minus 1/NC. So one example here, few example here. So what will be the classification error here? What will be the classification error here? And what will be the classification error here? It is very simple. Here classification error means majority of pattern belongs to class C2, so the error will be 1/6. Here whatever you say is, and here there is no error, so it will be 1. So now here we see is one example here, that is misclassification error versus Gini index. We have three metrics. Now if you compare with the misclassification error with the Gini, let's say in this case here, what will be the Gini here? Gini value is 0.42. So same way you compute, what is that Gini formula? 1 minus summation over PGT square. So here two classes, so 7/10² + 3/10², right? So that is the Gini value. So let's say we got this Gini value is 0.42. Now if you split, so that is the distribution after splitting. So we have the classes C1, C2. So and then node wise distribution is like that, 3, 0 and 4, 3. So in this node we will get the maximum Gini value or minimum Gini value. What will be the Gini for this node N1? It will be 0, right? 1 minus max value, so 3 by, because there is no other class here. So that is here. So Gini of this node will be 0. And Gini of this node will be 1 minus 4/7² - 3/. So Gini of this node will be 0.4. Now combined Gini will be 0.32. So earlier it was 0.42, now you are getting the Gini value is 0.342. So there is an improvement after split. So we should go. But what have happened? So this is the combined Gini, as you know. But what happened if you use the classification error? So what was the classification error at this node? Classification error was 3/10, so for 3 pattern you will make mistake. And then what will be the combined classification error? For this node, there is no classification error because all pattern belong to single. But what will be the classification error for this node? Total number of, you have to combine the total number of objects were 10, so it will be 3/10. So therefore, Gini improves, but the error remains same. This is very important. So therefore, actually error rate hardly use any application. So there are decision tree where we use the Gini or entropy, but error rate hardly used while splitting the decision tree. Maybe it is used for some other application. So this is one more example here. So this is another distribution, or it is same, and here is different distribution. So what will be the error for this one? Total error, say for this node, for this object there will be error, and for this node, this object, these two objects will be error. So total number of error is 3. So total number of pattern is, total number of objects is 10. So then error will be 3/10. So this is a misclassification error for all three cases is 0.3. Now this is the last slide today. So that is for the two class problem. So how the value changes for the two class problem? So this is the probability of one class. So the two class problem means probability of one class is 0.9. So therefore, probability of other class will be 0.9. So probability of one class is 0.5. So probability of other class will be 0.5. So then misclassification error, what will be the misclassification error, misclassification error? So let's say one class probability is 0.1. So then other class is 0.9. So what will be the misclassification error? 0.1. So what is this formula? 1 minus max j p j t. So 0.1 and 0.9, which one is maximum? 0.9. So this will give you 0.1. So therefore, error will be 0.1. Similarly, say let's say among these two classes, one probability is 0.9. So here again 0.9, what will be the error? 0.1. So therefore, this is also 0.1. And for two class problem, what we have seen, what is the Gini value maximum? What is the maximum Gini value? We have seen 0. Obviously, it is 0. One class is 0. So all other classes may be obviously 1. So then this value will be 0. But when it is equally probable, that is 0.5, probability is 0.5 for the both classes, what will be the maximum value? That is the Gini value, right? 1 minus half. So that is, it is showing that is the Gini value is, I think it should be somewhere here, 0.5. Similarly, when 0.5, all classes distribution is equal, we will get the highest value, that is entropy. So if it is, we have three class problem, then we have to see the other probability also, because it is easier if you get the one class probability 0.1. So we easily can identify the other class probability will be 0.9. So that is already I talked here, that you stop expanding a node when all records or all objects belong to the same class, or all record have the similar attribute value. So you further you cannot divide. But some, and again you can put some other restriction, like if the number of objects in a node is very less, then you should not split again. So these are the good thing for the decision tree here. So it is inexpensive to construct, extremely fast after while classifying, because you have to trace the tree only, and it is easy to interpret, and it is equally good with the some other class. If you compare with the other classification technique, its performance is equally good. Okay, so these are the disadvantages of the decision tree. So I stop here. Okay.